praise men say. Only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you. Shall I stay? Would it be a sin if I can't help falling in love with?
Well, marriage is a time when a growing love is made public, when a man and a woman commit their love and their life with promises to one another in the very presence of God and witnesses. On behalf of Mike and Cindy, they personally welcome each one here, and they thank you for coming to share in their wedding celebration. If everyone would stand in honor of the brothers and bow your hearts in prayers, we ask God to bless us their wedding and the love for each other. Father God, we bring Mike and Cindy before you and ask you to bless us their wedding celebration, their love for each other, and a special blessing upon the rings exchanged as a symbol of the marriage covenant they enter into with promises. As they make their promises this day to one another, I pray their very hearts will melt to them. And a special blessing upon the families that have come together through this union. May they always be sweethearts, helpmates, and friends through the glad and the sad times of life. As we ask for your spirit and peace to be with each one now, as we give you all honor, glory, and praise. In Jesus Christ's name, amen. You may be seated. Marriage is a promise that two hearts gladly make. It's a promise to be tender, to care, to help, to give and take. Marriage is a promise to share one life together, and it's a love promise meant to be kept forever. And as I say these promises, give them to each other from your hearts. I promise to give you the best of myself, to ask of you no more than you can give. I promise to accept you the way that I fell in love with you, for your qualities, your abilities, and I will not reshape you in a different image. And I promise to respect you with your own interests, desires, and needs, and yours different, but no less important than my own. And finally, I promise to love you through good and difficult times, with all I have to give and all I feel inside, completely and forever. If you make these promises to one another, say, I do.
I do.
In the very presence of God and witnesses, do you take this woman to be your lawful wedded wife?
I do.
In the presence of God and witnesses, you take this man to be your lawful wedded husband?
I do.
Do you promise to love each other, be ever faithful to one another, stand by each other's side, forsaking all others, and receive each other from this moment on for better or worse, richer or poorer, sickness and health, for as long as you both shall live? If so, say I do.
I do.
You're giving and receiving the wedding ring, which is a symbol of the marriage covenant that you enter into with your promises, your love to one another, your commitment to each other as husband and wife. So from this day forward, every time you look upon your rings, you're going to know you're not alone in this life. You have someone who loves you, your true love, your best friend, the one that's always going to be there for you. And they are made of a precious metal that is least tarnished and it fears no flames. When it goes in the fire, it comes out purer than when it went in. And that's how your marriage and love will always work as long as you both submit to one another. So at this time, if you'd hand your flowers next to you, and if the rings would be given to the bride and groom for each other. As the groom places a wedding ring on the bride's wedding ring finger and then holds her hands and looks into her eyes and repeats after me, I love you, Cindy.
I love you, Cindy.
With all my love. With all my love.
All my
and promises.
Promises.
With this ring.
This ring.
I be wed.
Wed.
Now in turn, as the bride places the ring in the groom's wedding ring. Holds his hand, looks into his eyes, and repeats after me, I love you, Mike.
I love you, Mike.
And with all my love.
With all my love.
And promises.
And promises.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I be wed.
I be wed.
You're about to take part of the Unity Candle Ceremony, which is a part of your wedding celebration. Instead of separate lights in life, today you join your life, your marriage, and your love in unity with one another and your unity with Christ. As you light the unity candle, you blow out the individual candles before you step back where you are. So if the best man would just take a step back, and if the groom would come with the bride up his side. As you pick up your individual candles, just dedicate your life, your marriage, and your love. Come in unity with one another and your unity with Christ. It would be our hope that wherever you make your home, you designate a permanent spot. Put a vase, two red roses that fit in, for a red rose is a symbol of love. And every year on your wedding anniversary, at least celebrate it by both of you bringing a red rose, placing it in the vase as a renewal, a recommitment of your love and promises you entered into as husband and wife. And then during the year, if things happen, words can't resolve, if just one of you bring a red rose and place in the vase as a statement of your love, the other would see and accept it. And I see you do have a special love that's scratching here today. It shows in your eyes, which are the windows of your heart. And the good news is it will grow deeper, richer, stronger, and purer because of your commitment with promises, the trust you have in each other, your love for one another, and the most important of God's presence and blessings upon your life, your marriage, and your love. And you are standing by your true love, your best friend. Always bring honor, respect to your relationship, and wherever you go, whatever you do, be each other's best representatives. Do you both accept this charge today? If so, say I do.
I do.
Therefore, it is with great honor, by authority vested in me as ordained minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, by the laws of the state of Nevada, to proudly pronounce you husband and wife. You may seal with a big kiss while everybody as they get ready to take the first stroll down the aisle as husband and wife.
Surprise.